Caroline Holden. I'm one of the leaders of the SALSA project. And this is Olivia and Carmen. They are PhD students from Victoria University in Wellington, and they're going to be like using the data that we're collecting during the next 18 months on this beautiful part of the country. How do we get the data out? We're going to be listening to earthquakes, really, really small earthquakes. And all these boxes that you see here are like seismic sensors.
Well, Caroline, can we, you know, Coasters, you're live here at the moment, you're probably wondering what we're talking about, but we've got a team out at 3 Mile here in Hokitika, and they're part of it's a worldwide project, isn't it?
That's right, yes. Yeah, so we have international colleagues as well, and in terms of the size and the extent of that project is really unique as well. We're going to have a sensor every 10 kilometers.
Wow.
So it's really dense, and it's never been done before on this part of the world as well.
So you'll be able to give me a ring and tell me when the next earthquake's going to come.
Well, we would like to, but these instruments will not talk to us live. So you're still going to have to rely on GeoNet, our beautiful network, national network, to get your earthquake data. These guys will be sitting on the ground, and we're going to have to be talking to them every 6 months or so.
Can we have a look?
Yes, what are we, come on in.
What's this young lady doing?
So here we've got Olivia. She's testing.
Hello, how are you?
A GPS antenna.
Yeah,
maybe if we can move to one of the
sites
that we are already put together. So,
gosh, actually it looks expensive.
It's really expensive.
Is
and
it?
So the beauty of this thing is we couldn't afford it. This is actually really expensive, high technology instruments. And they've been lent to us from the USA, from New Mexico, a project called Pascal.
Right.
And these guys have like tons of instruments, and they lend it to us to do this kind of like project. And it's all for, you know, the science good and for a better world and all that. So
these sensors, will they go right along the fault line, I guess?
That's right. So I should have a map here, but we don't have a map. Basically, they're going to be spread along the Alpine Fault.
Yep.
We're going to have about 50 of those. And so not all those machines are instruments. This is the sensor here. So in this like metal box here, you have a really sensitive seismic sensors.
Yes.
That can really record really small magnitude earthquakes. But it doesn't work by itself. So that's why you have lots of cables and machines here. That sensor talks to that orange machine here.
The thing there, yeah.
And that one captures the signal and digitizes it, so it turns it into ones and zeros, so that you can have a signal that you can use on your computer, and scientists like us can look at those recordings.
So what do you hope to get out of it?
So two things. So first, we're going to have every sensor is going to shed a new light on the fault. You're going to be able to capture really small earthquakes, and every earthquake tells you something about the behavior of the fault. Right.
Right.
And so because we're going to, at the moment we have 3 sensors from GeoNet, we're going to have 50.
Goodness me.
And so imagine it's just having, just more lights shown onto the fault. So we're going to have a better picture of what the fault is like at the moment.
So Caroline, where will they go from? I guess down Haast there somewhere?
Yep. So they go all the way from, this is the northern part of our deployment.
Yes.
So we start around here, Hokitika, Springs Junction. So that's the northernmost part of Springs Junction, really.
Yep.
And then we're going to be deploying them, rolling them out as we go further south, all the way to Milford Sound.
Wow, you're going to see the country as well.
Yes, everyone's really excited.
So,
and the weather's good today too. So we already have 2 teams that have made the most of the good weather. They've already gone out and put 2 sites together.
Well, it's always like that here. Weather's always beautiful.
Sure. I've been here 20 years.
I've been sprung, Coasters.
Yeah.
I've been sprung. So these things, and do they get covered up? Are they in some sort of...
That's right. So
who's this young lady?
This is Carmen.
She looks like she knows what she's doing.
She's our bright PhD student. Yes. And so she's testing one of the setup that will be on site, deployed on site in the next few weeks. So we need to test them first, because you don't want to be out there, in the middle of nowhere and realize something's not quite working. So even though they've been lent to us, from a really reliable institute, we
sometimes
still need to make sure, they've traveled quite a bit. We need to make sure that they work, that the cables are all there. And it's good practice for us as well to be fast.
And have we had an earthquake since you've been here?
We've had, so my colleague Emily Warren-Smith, she's out on the field already, but she recorded some earthquakes already overnight. the small ones, you know, made you twos.
Yeah, okay.
That, you know, you don't really hear from those ones, but this kind of instruments can capture really, really small magnitudes. So, yeah.
And is this part of, this is not, is this part of the AF8 program, or is it?
No, so it's not part of AF8, but we're strongly, you know, AF8 is a huge program. It's really looking at the resilience parts of our future alpine fault earthquakes and the impact of it. And so what we're doing here is we hope to be providing more realistic model of the future earthquakes. So eventually, we hope IFA will be able to use our models to just have, you know, more realistic ground shaking scenario that to test civil defense and all that. So
if an earthquake hit in Fiordland, is there much time before we'd feel it here in Haugatinga?
No, it's really fast. Yeah. So how far is Fiordland from?
It's 450 kilometers.
Oh, 400. Yeah. Yeah, you'd have a few minutes.
Oh, really?
Yeah, maybe a minute or two before it shakes here. But it's.
Oh, I love it. Gosh, look at the technology.
It's amazing, isn't it? Yeah, and so it looks. That's why we need to have the right training. And so we've been actually getting online training from the USA yesterday and today, this morning again, just to get familiar with their equipment. But the project leader, Professor John Townend, he's very familiar with that part of the country and with seismic deployment as well. He was involved in the Alpine Fault drilling project as well a few years ago.
So do you helicopter in?
So we're going to do, yeah. So the further south we go, the harder the terrain is. And we're going to be relying on a helicopter to get us up there.
I love it.
On the field, yes.
Well, look, Caroline, thanks so much for taking the time to talk to
pleasure,
us.
Yes.
And look, good luck with the project.
Thank you very much. And we hope, you know, to keep communicating our results. And and if anyone's interested, we have a wee Facebook site as well.
What's it called?
It's called facebook.com/SALSA. So SALSA for Southern Alps Skinny Array. This is our, we have T-shirts, actually.
Oh, of course. There
they're
we go.
Still, like, quite clean.
SALSA, S-A-L-S-A.
That's right. So SALSA, E-Q-N-Z, because there was already a SALSA group on Facebook.
I'll go and have a look. And
so we're SALSA, E-Q-N-Z.
Well, look, thanks so much for talking to me. I really appreciate it.
Pleasure.
And good luck with the project.
And we'll have more interesting footage, you know, once we're out there in the field as well. So
wonderful.
Yeah.
We'll catch you later.
Thank you.